surface is melting away the asphalt. Park officials have closed the 3-mile-long roadway known as Firehole Lake Drive and have asked visitors to park on the sides of the road. Park officials warned that stepping on the seemingly solid asphalt could create an illusion, and you could quickly find yourself stepping into hot water. Literally. Park officials say it's basically turning the gravel into oatmeal. This roadway is the main access to such geysers as Old Faithful, the Great Fountain, White Dome, and of course, Firehole Lake. Maintenance teams will now remove the melted asphalt from the roadway and apply sand and lime to absorb the rest. And they hope to have that road open again by next week.
Joining us now is Derek Pitts. He's the Chief Astronomer and Planetarium Programs Director at the Franklin Institute Science Museum in Philadelphia. Good morning, Derek.
Good morning.
So you're here to scare us.
Absolutely.
It's 2.5 times the size of what we thought.
Yes.
How significant is that?
Well, it's really significant because the magma chamber below Yellowstone, it measures about 55 miles wide, 20 miles in length, and it's 6 miles below the surface. This chamber is absolutely packed full of magma, and an eruption from this could really cause widespread destruction all across that region.
As if that was not scary enough, some of the experts now are saying they have no idea when this eruption could take place.
Yeah, there are plenty of earthquakes that happen out there, as you said a little bit earlier, but those earthquakes are indicative of the activity that's going on below ground. Some of it may be caused by water intrusion and other things like that, but the fact of the matter is that there were 3 eruptions of this region before. There's definitely going to be another one in the future. Scientists just can't tell when.
When you say future, though, the reality is this could be real, like 40,000 years future. Is that right?
Yeah, it really could be. We have no idea, though, but there will always be adjusting earthquakes in that region, so that region will remain seismically active. It will also be volcanically active. There will be small volcanic eruptions in that region. It's just the big one that people really have to be concerned about. And if we can get the science a little bit more refined, we'll have a better idea of when we might have some ballpark idea of when to expect something might happen.
Okay, so now you're starting to comfort me a little bit, because I was going to ask you here. I was going to say, are we going to get any warning, like maybe a century or so, that this thing's coming?
The really cool thing about how science is working in seismology and volcanology these days is that scientists can really model the area well, because there are seismic detectors, 40 of them, all around the region, measuring in different ways, and essentially taking an x-ray, if you will, of the ground below, so that they can figure out what's going on better and have a better way to get a grip on how to say when something could possibly be coming.
How were the earlier estimates so undervalued? I mean, how come scientists didn't realize how big that well was?
Well, it's very difficult to have any idea of what's going on underground. I mean, we're looking at something that is 6 to 9 miles below the surface of the Earth. It's enormous. We never thought that the magma chamber could be that big, and so we didn't know what the parameters were around which we had to measure. But now that there are so many more sensors coming to the site to be used, you know, the advances in technology and model making and things like that help scientists to get a better picture, so we have a better idea, more accurate than in the past. Sort of 30,000 years ago was measured to be about 2,000 times greater than the Mount St. Helens eruption. 2,000 times bigger. That's enormous. It's enough to, the last eruption spread 10 feet of ash in regions 1,000 miles away. So that's a pretty big eruption.
I mean, Yellowstone National Park is also located in a really seismically active region, isn't it?
Well, you have to think that the whole region essentially is the basin of an ancient volcano, under which is this enormous sort of chamber of magma that's causing the region to heat.